Many Americans have a skewed perception of Japan, as skewed, perhaps, as many foreigners have of America, many of whom seem to expect cowboys and Indians. Of Japan, the image arises of the feudal samurai, the ritual harikari, visions of what Westerners like to call the inscrutable Orient. From such a martial, warlike history, one wonders what kind of justice system has evolved. Rates of homicide, rape, robbery, and theft are far, far lower than other industrial societies such as the U.S., England, and Germany. Why are these rates so low in Japan? If America's conventional wisdom holds true, Japan must be building plenty of prisons, levying increasingly harsh sentences, and subjecting prisoners to draconian conditions, right? Wrong. University of Washington Law and Eastern Asian Studies professor John O'Haley, author of Mediation and Criminal Justice, opines that the Japanese veer away from retribution and revenge and towards restoration and social reconciliation. According to statistics published by the Supreme Court of Japan, the following median prison terms were returned for the following offenses. 1. Homicide, 5 to 7 years. 2. Robbery, 3 to 5 years. 3. Arson, 3 to 5 years. 4. Rape, 2 to 3 years. The median term for all criminal offenses combined was 1 to 2 years. Persons sentenced to prison rarely serve over one term in Japan. For example, in 1984, 64,990 persons were sentenced to prison. Of that total, 56% received suspended sentences, with less than 13% being subjected to prison terms exceeding 1 year. More surprisingly, 25% of those with suspended sentences were convicted of homicide or robbery, and of those convicted of arson or rape, 35% of the sentences were suspended. Only about 45% of all imprisoned persons serve full terms. American critics view the Japanese penal practice with incredulity, if not outright amazement, and hasten to note the sharp distinctions in culture between the U.S. and Japan. Curiously, American industrialists and economists raise few cultural barriers when attempting to incorporate Japanese business and managerial wisdom to the U.S. workplace. Seemingly, what works in a factory environment becomes unmanageable in the prison context. But truth be told, U.S. prisons are themselves in a state nearing physical, social, ideological collapse, as over 1 million persons serve sentences, many set to expire, if at all, far into the next century. U.S. prisons, far from being a place of restoration, are social sinkholes of despair, of degradation, of spiritual death. We could learn much from the Japanese, more than how to build a better mousetrap. From Death Row, this is Mumia Abu Jamal.